So the presentation is divided in three sections. First, I'll introduce Porsche industry. Secondly, I'll present you our strategy on smart material development. And then I'll show you several developments we've been working on. Porsche industry designs and manufactures technical materials such as textile and composite in the field of aerospace and defense, automotive, construction, energy, and sports. Our research and innovation function is renowned for being customer-focused and adaptable, constantly ambitious, and striving to successfully develop new solutions across our active research project. Based on our core competencies on weaving, any type of fiber, glass, carbon, synthetic, and bio-based fibers, and combining chemistry with textile, we offer a wide range of thermoplastic composites in a high-performance textile. So now you know a bit more about Porsche industry. Let's move on to the next part, which is why developing smart materials. Even if the wearable industry is well known for its integration of smart material since more than 10 years, the integration of sensor and electronics in technical materials is one of the key challenges that needs to be addressed. The objectives are to develop durable materials and an intuitive interface that integrate the comfort of simple function or create new interactive features with their environment. We are creating the future. Our materials are becoming smart. Our innovation center is working on a major technology leap to functionalize textiles with sensors and actuators. The benefits of these technologies are the flexibility and the durability technical textile offers. The solution developed consists in a fully integrated system, the smart component, the electronic, and the data system analysis. So let's move on to the capacitive contactless sensor, which is the first demonstrator that I'm going to show you. So the capacitive sensor I'm talking about is a non-contact device that can detect the presence or the absence of virtually any object, regardless the type of material. It uses the electrical property of the capacitance, and a change of this capacitance is based on a change in the electrical field around the active phase of the sensor. Many types of sensors use capacitive sensing, including sensor to detect and measure proximity, position, and displacement, as well as force and pressure. So I'm going to show you the first video. This technology has been developed in partnership with Fogal Robotics. So I'm just going to need some small time to show the video. Here we go. So the smart textile can be used for position detection. It allows the localization of a conductive object or human away from the textile. The key benefits of implementing such a smart function on a textile is the flexibility of this substrate, which enables to fold the material as much as you can, and the signal would still be stable and efficient. The distance can also be detected, as this technology is contactless, which means an object can be detected up to 15 centimeters away from the textile. All right. So in other words, we are able to develop sensor function on a textile for which its mechanical properties are preserved. The use of textile instead of plastronic allows us to obtain flexible, droppable, and stable system, either dimensionally or thermically. Finally, this technology can be implemented on any kind of textile. So the second sensor I'm going to present is a capacitive touch technology. The difference between the contactless technology presented previously is the ability to develop touchscreen application. Self-capacitance touch sensor uses a single sensor electrode to measure the apparent capacitance between the electrode and the ground of the touch sensor circuit. Various designs have been tested in order to evaluate the process capability. The first application is a simple command button to switch on and off the OLED panel. A button is a single sensor and is interpreted as a binary state. In detect or out of detect. In this example, we use two buttons, but it's also possible to use a single button if needed. The second type of touchscreen sensor we've developed is a slider. The slider mechanism is based on the same one as the simple command button. However, the slider enables to increase or decrease the signal intensity of the OLED panel. It could also be used to increase a power supply, for example. And the last video represents the touchscreen technology on a more complex environment. This textile has been hanged up onto our friendly robot. And as you can see, even if the textile is in this position, the structure of the textile is such as the signal is stable, allowing a consistent signal to switch on and off the OLED panel. So the sensor we developed in-house can be tailor-made depending on your application. This technology is suitable for any kind of textile, and most importantly, it can be integrated in composite material. The last technology to be presented is the temperature control and heating textile. So two animations will follow. The first one is the representation of the heating Joule's effect obtained with the specific conductive ink. And on the top of the textile, or on the same textile, it is possible to add a temperature sensor in order to control the temperature increase. The signal can then be read on the screen. The key benefits of using our textile is its resistance to high temperature. Our system is stable until 150 degrees. We are working on higher temperature usage. The integration of the heating function is a thermal sensor can be done in a two-dimensional plan. Finally, the flexibility of our design is such as the signal is highly homogeneous. So in conclusion, we have the ability to develop tailor-made designs. We can use any kinds of textile, which gives flexibility, droppability, and durability, as well as thermal stability. And we can integrate those sensors into composite materials. So finally, let's have a look at our film in motion design. It doesn't seem to work, so let me try again. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this presentation. So now we can move on to the Q&A session. The first question is, thank you. Can the capacitive sensor be used in a 3D woven composite structure? It's not something that we've investigated yet, but it's definitely something that might be possible under some investigation. Don't hesitate to contact us. Can the heating heat be laminated between composites? Yes, definitely. This is what we are working on. Okay, next question. Is there another question? I'm a PhD and I want to get data for fiber orientation, deformation in 2D layup. Can we also extract these values and automate them? About the data extraction, we would need some more information. I'm not sure I'll get your question right. It would be something possible under some electronics development, but not in our case, in any case. We are working on deformation sensor. And again, if you're interested, don't hesitate to contact us. To what temperature are your printed circuits stable? It's stable until 150 degrees, but we're working on increasing this temperature resistance. Our integration in the can alter the sensitivity of the sensor. This is something we are looking at. And at the moment, so far, on the signal that we investigated, there is a shift, but it depends on the sensitivity that you're looking for. Can these tissues be molded behind the CF layer for visible carbon lux part? Well, the use of carbon... it would need to be tested. This is not something that we've looked at the moment, but yeah, it's definitely an interesting question. Is there another question? The limits by the folding properties, we design our smart textile in order to be as resistant as a standard textile would be. So the limits are the same as the current textile offers. So the flexibility is something we manage quite well. So I would say there is no limit on the folding properties. Can this fabric help detect effects up to 15 centimeters in composite? Not at the moment, but it would depend on the design of the sensor. Our technology at the moment is working on sensibility up to 15 centimeters. But if you're interested, this is something we can eventually look at for a wider range of detection. But obviously, if you increase the distance of detection, you decrease the sensitivity of your sensor. How many times it could be bent, for example, to 90 degrees? We've done some tests. We've got flexibility. Well, those are specific tests that we perform on our textile. So it's more than 90 degrees that we can bend. And our cycle are around 1,200 times, but it would depend on the final application that you're targeting. I see the time is running. So what I suggest is if you please could stay tuned a little bit longer in order to fill in the form. If you've got any more questions, please don't hesitate to contact us. So first, the satisfaction question. If you'd like to be contacted back, please fill in the survey. All right, thank you. I see that it's already started. So the different questions are you interested with this technology? Which technology is the most interesting? Would you be interested in another sensor? And do you plan to implement such a technology in your business and when? Which industry sector do you operate in? And if you want to be contacted by Porsche, please give us your contact detail and your role in your company so we can contact you back. Okay, so I see everybody replied to, not everybody, but a lot of you replied to this survey. So I'm gonna end the vote now. And if you'd like to contact us, please don't hesitate. Here are our address, email address. And thank you a lot for your attendance. Goodbye.